Hey guys, I was actually thinking, you know, this past weekend has been very, like, weird for us. And, you know, we've always been doing the schoolwork and we haven't been able to focus on, like, religion and stuff. You know, so I was thinking about, like, doing maybe a Christian group, you know, after school, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, something like that. Just to, like, you know, go back to our religion, since we've been focusing too much on many other things.
Yeah, I agree with you, Danny. We should do the Christian group every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. We could even do it in here. It's a great idea. I like it.
Well, I actually do think it's a good idea, but if we're going to do a group, we need to find a sponsor, because if not, this can go to court if we do get caught, if we do it on the low. So, you know, it's just up to you guys. I think if we do it on the low, we just come in here, and that's about it. You know, like, it's not, nobody will really know.
Okay, formations of actual religious-led organizations can't be initiated by faculty members. However, if it's student-initiated, it can be held as long as they have a sponsor. And if they meet on campus, it's not a cross of church and state because it is student-initiated and led.
Guys, we got caught. Basically, they told me at the court where we had gone to that since it was just a student-run group, we can't do this anymore. We spoke to everybody, and basically, since it's student-led, there's no way we can do it because it's considered illegal, and it's a difference between church and state.